Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm Victoria from Keep You Holistic, where I talk about healthy living, motherhood, and more. And today I'm going to be talking about the supplements that I take during pregnancy. Now I want to say first off that these are not supplements that every pregnant woman should be taking. I'm not recommending supplements to you. You really need to talk to your doctor and do your own research before taking any kind of supplement. But these are the ones I take, and they are pretty, I'd say they're pretty general, like the ones that most pregnant women could take. One of them, I'd say, or one or two of them are more specific to conditions that I have, but I'll just kind of go over everything that I take. And it's funny because when I was starting to make this video, I was like, oh, probably just be a couple of supplements. This is going to be a really short video. And then when I was looking at the amount of supplements, I was like, wow, I actually take like quite a bit more than I thought I do. So I'm going to get into them now. Okay, so I'm going to be doing the refrigerated supplements first, and this one is not one that I'm taking right now. Like, I haven't taken this in a while. I was taking this, but I was on the GAP side, and I still have like leftover probiotics. So BioCult is a probiotic, and you can also get Prescriptisys. I think that's another one that people like. You want like a really strong probiotic. You don't just want to take like the cheap ones at the drugstore. You want like something that's actually going to work, and usually you want to get ones that are refrigerated because those are typically the stronger ones. You want to do your research, but I'm taking, well, when I need to take probiotics, I take the BioCult, and I'm not going to be taking this until I get into the end of my pregnancy, closer to the birth. I'm going to start taking around then, because around 36 weeks is when they do the group B strep test, and then of course you're going to be giving birth vaginally, hopefully, and you want to make sure you have really good bacteria in there from when the baby is exiting the birth canal. And when they do the group B strep test, you know, if you take probiotics that can help reduce the chances of it coming back positive, it's not a guarantee. If you're having any kind of, you know, gut health related issues while pregnant, then, you know, you might want to take a probiotic in that case. But most of the time you can get your probiotics from fermented food. So this I take every single day. This is cod liver oil. This is the Rosita. I take about a teaspoon of it. The Weston A Price Foundation recommends for pregnant women take 2 teaspoons. I honestly can't afford to buy 2 of these bottles every month. I can only like afford 1. So I just take 1 teaspoon every single day. And this is a really good source of vitamin A and D, which are important for fetal development. I'm not going to get too much into this. I talked about it already in my Weston A. Price pregnancy diet video. So you can check that out. And how I take it is I will take it with some orange juice. So I pour out my orange juice first. So every day I take a teaspoon of cod liver oil. Okay, so I got that in the refrigerator. So next I want to talk about D-mannose, and D-mannose is for urinary tract infections. So myself, along with a lot of other pregnant women, are more prone to urinary tract infections while pregnant. So this pregnancy so far, no urinary tract infection, because I remember to take this every single day. And what D-mannose is, it's a type of cranberry sugar. So this type of sugar binds to E. coli bacteria in the urinary tract. So when it binds the bacteria, you know, it prevents it from getting stuck in the kidneys and bladder and stuff like that, and it helps you flush it out of your system. So it binds to it and then it allows your body to flush it out. So that's why I take this every day. It's a preventative, and if you are, you know, prone to urinary tract infections, pregnant or not, you can take this. It's just cranberry sugar, it's not harmful. So I started to talk about this one before. This is emu oil, and this is the Walkabout brand. I don't know if you can see it too well, but this is emu oil, and what it's for is vitamin K2, and vitamin K2 works really well with vitamins A and D. Especially it helps make sure that, you know, calcium is getting to the right places in your body, but it works really well with the cod liver oil, so that's why I take it as well. So this one is desiccated beef thyroid from Ancestral Supplements, and I'm taking this because I have some thyroid problems, and so this is helping me. It's actually working because I've been doing blood work, and it's showing that my levels have been getting better. So this is helpful for thyroid problems, like pregnant or not. Of course, always do your research. I'll have a link down below more about thyroid health, and also talk to your doctor. It's hard to get a prescription. It's hard to find a more naturally minded doctor that will prescribe this, but do your research and you may be able to find somebody in your area if you're having thyroid problems, and if you're, you know, you want to get off like Synthroid or something, you know, so do your own research on that. It also has liver in it, so it's kind of, it's not as much as their liver supplement. Like, they have a dedicated liver supplement, the dehydrated liver. A lot of people take that, especially if you can't do liver. I can't really do the organ meats. So next I want to talk about minerals, and minerals are really important during pregnancy. A lot of women struggle, and men too, struggle with mineral deficiencies because our soils are more depleted from all the industrial farming and stuff like that. It's harder to get minerals through our diet. So I do this magnesium oil spray, and I do it also for my anxiety. It helps me relax before I go to sleep. So magnesium oil spray is the easiest way to get magnesium into your body. It absorbs better than doing like a pill. So this, the topical spray is what I recommend. And you know, I do like 6-10 sprays. It just depends on your individual tolerance. You'll know if you've had too much if it makes you go to the bathroom. So if you suddenly get the runs, then you probably have taken too much and just want to like dial back. But just, you know, you'll feel like a tingling, itchy feeling when you spray it on. So this is kind of something I take while I'm pregnant and when I'm not pregnant. Also, in terms of minerals, this pregnancy, I've really had some issues with my teeth more than other pregnancies. This is my third. So obviously my body is a little bit more depleted this time. I'm hoping to heal my, or cure tooth decay. If you're interested in that, I can link the Cure Tooth Decay book down below. It has a lot of good information about how to naturally heal cavities. So I take trace mineral drops, and I do that in the orange juice. And then I also do this, these cell salts, and there's different types of cell salts. I just, right now I'm taking the combination of all the salts. It's also helpful for remineralization as well. It helps with like headaches and stuff too, if you have that. And then my midwife is having me take red raspberry leaf tea in my second trimester. And I did a whole video about that, why, you know, the benefits and stuff, but basically it's really good for strengthening and toning the uterus. So because this is my third baby, my uterus is a little bit less toned. It's had a little bit of a workout. It's getting a little tired, I guess. I'm trying to take it every day. It's hard to remember. I get kind of lazy, like, you know, standing there like boiling water and stuff. So I think those are all the supplements I'm taking, and not all of them I take every single day. So I hope this was informative. Maybe it will guide your research. Maybe, you know, it'll bring to your attention something that you haven't heard about before, and you're like, oh, that's really interesting. And then you do some research and you're like, oh, this might be beneficial to me. And you could bring it up to your doctor and see if it might be helpful. And if you have any questions about anything I talked about, you know, shoot me a comment. And I'm not recommending that you take, again, I'm not recommending you take any of these, but I hope that this is just like informative and will guide you in the right direction. And please be sure to like, share, and subscribe if you're interested in healthy living, you know, holistic lifestyle, Weston A. Price recipes. If you're interested in that, please subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you guys again soon. Be well, guys.